Let's now look beyond Bitcoin. Bitcoin blockchain is open source and the entire code is available on the GitHub. During the initial years, beginning roughly in 2009, this open source code was extended to release different cryptocurrencies. About 300 plus cryptocurrencies were introduced. Bitcoin supports an optional and special feature called scripts for conditional transfer of values. Ethereum blockchain extended the scripting feature into a full-blown code execution framework called smart contract. A smart contract provides the very powerful capability of code execution for embedding business logic on the blockchain. Based on such capabilities, three major types of blockchains emerge from Bitcoin Foundation. Type 1 deals with the coins and cryptocurrency chain, example Bitcoin. Type 2 supports cryptocurrency and a business logic layer supported by code execution, example Ethereum. Type 3 involves no currency but supports software execution for business logic, example the Linux Foundation's Hyperledger. With the addition of code execution comes the serious consideration about public access to the blockchain. Hence the classification of public, private, and permission blockchain based on access limits. We've been watching Bitcoin blockchain continuously operational since its inception, all supported by its public participants. Thus, Bitcoin is a fantastic example of a public blockchain class. Anybody can join and leave as they wish. Transaction blocks and the blockchain are publicly observable, even though participants are anonymous. It is open source. You can also create new coin digital currency by modifying the Bitcoin code. Wallet applications provide the basic interface to transfer value through the Bitcoin blockchain. In a private blockchain, access to the blockchain is limited to selected participants. For example, those participants within an organization. This restriction helps in simplifying the normal operations such as block creation and consensus model. The third classification of blockchain is permission blockchain, also called consortium blockchain. It is meant for a consortium of collaborating parties to transact on a blockchain for ease of governance, provenance, and accountability. For example, a consortium of all automobile companies or healthcare organizations. Permission blockchain has the benefits of a public blockchain with allowing only users with permission to collaborate and transact. In summary, significant innovations such as smart contracts have opened up broader applications for blockchain technology. Private and permission blockchain allow for controlled access to the blockchain, enabling many diverse business models.